I'm Dr. Meenakshi Mao, Assistant Professor, Zoology, Sri Samlaji Government College, Mandavya, Chittorgarh. Today, my topic is types of eggs. Eggs are of different types. So, we will see in later slides, eggs can be divided on the basis of proportion of yolk to the cytoplasm, on the basis of distribution of yolk, on the basis of shell, and on the basis of their determination. First of all, we will see on the basis of proportion of yolk to the cytoplasm. First, alacetyl egg. The amount of yolk is very, very small or absent in this type of eggs. This type of eggs are found in eutherian mammals. The term alacetyl was given by Kent. Now, microlacetyl or oligolacetyl eggs. These eggs have a small or negligible amount of yolk. Example is Amphioxus and Tunicates. Mesolacetyl eggs. Amount of yolk is moderate and not high. These type of eggs are present in amphibians, dipnoi, petromyzon. Now, macrolacetyl eggs, which are also known as megalacetyl and polylacetyl. They contain large amount of yolk. This type of eggs are present in reptiles, birds, Prototheria, that is Monotremata, and insects. Now, eggs can also be classified on the basis of distribution of yolk. First, isolacetyl eggs, which are also known as homolacetyl eggs. They have very little amount of yolk present. But yolk is uniformly distributed throughout the ooplasm. This type of eggs are present in echinoderms, amphioxus, and mammals. Now, centrolacetyl eggs. These eggs have a large amount of yolk. And nucleus of this egg lies at the geometric center of the yolk mass, which is surrounded by a small amount of cytoplasm. This type of eggs are present in arthropods and some coelenterates. Now, telolacetyl eggs. These eggs contain moderate or large amount of yolk. The distribution of yolk is not uniform. Yolk is concentrated more towards the one pole, that is vegetal pole. Such type of eggs in which yolk is concentrated towards one pole called telolacetyl eggs. Telolacetyl eggs may further classified into three types: slightly telolacetyl, moderately telolacetyl, and extremely telolacetyl. Slightly telolacetyl eggs contain only a small amount of yolk, which is distributed unevenly. The vegetal pole has the highest concentration, but the animal pole has the lower concentration. These types of eggs are found in fishes. Moderately telolacetyl. This type of eggs contains a moderate quantity of yolk, and yolk is distributed unevenly. Because of the high concentration of yolk in the vegetal hemisphere, the nucleus is shifted more towards the animal hemisphere. This type of eggs are found in amphibian eggs. Now, extremely telolacetyl eggs. This type of eggs, due to heavy deposition of yolk, the entire vegetal hemisphere and a major portion of the animal hemisphere are occupied by yolk. And due to this extremely uneven distribution of yolk, the ooplasm and nucleus are displaced towards the animal pole. And this type of situation is found in reptilians and aves. Now, mosaic and regulative eggs. First, we will see mosaic eggs. They are the eggs in which every portion are predetermined with respect to its potentialities for further development. If a small portion of such an egg is removed, what will be formed? A defective embryo will be formed. And why this happens? This happens because removal of a portion results in a permanent loss from the egg. And the remaining portion of the egg cannot make compensatory development to make good the lost part. This type of eggs, in which the future developmental potentialities are predetermined in the form of mosaic, they call mosaic or determinate eggs. These type of eggs are found in annelids, mollusks, and ascidians. Now, regulative egg or indeterminate eggs. In vertebrates and most of the invertebrates, the developmental potentialities are not predetermined in the eggs. And the removal of a small portion of the egg or even one or two early blastomeres will not affect the normal development. And this type of eggs in which future developmental potentialities are not predetermined, they are called regulative or indeterminate eggs. And this type of eggs are found in vertebrates and most of the invertebrates. Now, we will divide eggs on the basis of shell into cladoic egg and non-cladoic eggs. Cladoic eggs, they contain a thick and hard outermost shell. This hard shell is permeable for gases. And in them, yolk, salt and water is present in a large amount. Example, eggs of birds, reptiles, prototherians and insects. Now, non-cladoic eggs. Their egg membranes are very soft, and this type of eggs are found in all viviparous animals and egg-laying oviparous animals. Now we will see different type of eggs. First we will see insect egg. Insect egg is megalacetal or polylacetal. Why? Because in them, yolk is present in the center. They are called as centrolacetal eggs because yolk is present in them in the center. Two egg membranes are present. Inner vitellin membrane, see. And outer chorion, see. This is inner vitellin, this is outer chorion. The sperm enters the egg through micropyle because on the head of insect sperm, acrosome is absent. Now we will talk about cytoplasm. In them, cytoplasm is found in two parts. Central cytoplasm and peripheral cytoplasm. Central cytoplasm is present in a very small amount in the center of eggs. Egg nucleus is located in it. Now peripheral cytoplasm. It is present in very small amount along the periphery of the egg. So this is all about insect egg. Now, frog's egg. Frog egg is moderately telolecithal and mesolecithal. Two types of egg membranes are found in frog's egg. First is vitellin membrane and the other is jelly coat. This is vitellin membrane and this is jelly coat. Vitellin membrane is primary egg membrane, which is secreted by the ovum around itself. And jelly coat is a tertiary egg membrane, which is secreted by oviduct. Jelly coat has air bubbles trapped in it, due to which it floats in water. This group of frog's egg is called spawn. Jelly coat is bitter in taste, so enemies do not eat it. In frogs, secondary egg membrane is absent. Now we will talk about internal part of the egg. It is divided into two parts. Animal poll and vegetal poll. Animal poll has the cytoplasm. Egg nucleus is also located in this part. In the cytoplasm, melanin granules are formed, which prevent the egg from harmful radiations. And they also help in protection of egg by camouflage. A sperm always enters into the ovum at some point in animal hemisphere. This point is normally other than the animal pole itself. As the sperm enters into the ovum, taking some pigment granule with it, a gray crescent shape region appears in the equatorial zone, geometrically opposite the sperm entrance point. This is gray crescent. It forms due to the movement of some pigment granules away from it toward sperm entrance point. Actually, it marks the dorsal side of the future embryo. The area of sperm entrance point marks the anterior side of the future embryo. The side diagonally opposite to it in the vegetal hemisphere marks the future posterior side. Thus, the sperm entrance establishes the anterior, posterior and dorsoventral axis as well as bilateral symmetry of future embryo. Now, vegetal pool. Actually, yolk is concentrated in this part. Now, chick's egg. These eggs are megalocytal, polylocytal and discoidal eggs. In them, yolk is present in the center in the form of dense mass. See. The cytoplasm of the egg is in the form of disc above the yolk, which is termed as a germinal disc. See, this is a germinal disc. Yolk is of two types, yellow yolk and the white yolk. Yellow yolk has a more amount of phospholipids and is secreted during the night. White yolk has a less amount of phospholipids and secreted during the daytime. Both the types of yolks are arranged in alternate concentric rings. See, this is yellow, this is white. So they are in the form of concentric rings, layers. Pender was a scientist who discovered the third germinal layer, that is ectoderm, mesoderm and endoderm in chick egg. Around the egg, a porous shell of calcium carbonate is present and which is secreted by the cells of posterior ligamental part of the oviduct. In between the vitellin membrane and the shell membrane, albumin is filled, which is also called the white of magazine. It contains 13% protein, thick albumin fiber, termed as a chelza, which is also present in albumin part of egg. Now, mammalian egg. Mammalian egg have a very less amount of yolk, hence they are oligolecithal, isolecithal, microlecithal, and homolecithal. In mammalian eggs, two egg membranes are present, zona pellucida and corona rigida. See, this is zona pellucida and this is corona rigida. Zona pellucida is a transparent membrane like covering and is a primary membrane secreted by the ovum itself. Corona rigida is a layer of follicular cells. These cells are attached to the surface of the egg through the hyaluronic acid. And this is a secondary membrane which is secreted by the ovary. And these eggs don't have a tertiary membrane. And in mammalian egg, you can see pre-vitellin space over here, nucleus and cytoplasm. So it's all about different types of eggs. Thank you.